Perennial cellar dwellers for many of those years, the then Quebec Nordiques built a talented team through the draft, and by the beginning of the 1995-96 season, the team was in its first year after relocation to Denver and were among the most talented in the league. However, question marks surrounded their youth and inexperience and their goaltending. But it was a game that didn't even involve the Avalanche that had the most profound effect on their season. December 2nd, 1995, the Red Wings were at the Montreal Forum. Rookie Canadiens coach Mario Tremblay foolishly refused to pull Patrick Roy as Detroit scored goal after goal in the old Forum. Finally, after allowing 9 goals against and being mercilessly booed and jeered, Tremblay pulled his star netminder. Roy skated directly to the bench, went over to team president Ronald Corey, and told him that he had played his last game as a Canadien. Years later, Red Wings coach Scotty Bowman admitted that he feared Roy could get traded to Colorado during that game as the Wings were scoring goal after goal, and that is exactly what happened. Within a week, Pierre Lacroix had acquired Patrick Roy and Mike Keane from their former hated rivals. Roy's 2 Conn Smythe trophies made the Avalanche instant cup contenders. With Patrick in goal, head coach Mark Crawford was able to turn loose a potent offense led by the duo of Joe Sakic and Peter Forsberg. Sakic finished 3rd in the league in scoring with 120 points, while Forsberg was 5th with a career-high 116 points. 1995 Conn Smythe winner Claude Lemieux had 39 goals and 71 points in his first season with the Avs, and Valery Kamensky had a career-high 38 goals while averaging more than a point a game. The Canucks season had suffered a terrible blow in early November when Pavel Bure suffered a season-ending knee injury. Alexander Mogilny, acquired in the offseason from the Sabres, had helped to fill the void, scoring 55 goals and adding 107 points. He was among the top 10 in both categories. Captain Trevor Linden was 2nd on the team in scoring with 33 goals and 80 points. Super pest Esa Tikkanen had been picked up from St. Louis during the season and had averaged almost a point a game with the Canucks. Corey Hirsch and Kirk McLean had each played more than 40 games, with the inexperienced Hirsch posting the better numbers, but McLean's postseason experience made him the choice to start the series. While nobody questioned Colorado was the more skilled team, skeptics wondered if the Avs' talent could deliver in the playoffs. Twice in the previous 3 years, they had gone into a series as favorites, only to lose in 6 games. After finishing with 104 points during the season, their highest total in franchise history, fans in Denver had high expectations as they prepared for just the 2nd playoff game ever in the state of Colorado.
One of the top offensive threats for Colorado.
When the Colorado Avalanche made the big trade with Montreal, the Patrick Roy trade, Kovalenko was deemed expendable because Valery Kamensky was playing so well.
Here's Lume moving in, can't control it in the corner.
But again, he was in behind the Colorado defense.
Alexander Mogilny one hands to Tikkanen, and a glove stop by Patrick Roy, who has been the story in the first 7 minutes of the hockey game.
Here's Esa Tikkanen on the one-hand pass from Mogilny. Roy's out, down he goes, the left hand out. What a save by Patrick Roy on that. Joe Sakic without the stick. Good solid hit. Patrick Roy talked about angles. He's usually deep in his net, but this one he comes out.
The ACL injury in the first game of the regular season, similar to that of Pavel Bure. Now Linden has Cortnell alone. Here's Russ Cortnell in alone. Cortnell scores!
Cortnell head up all the way, head up, looks, and waited for Patrick Roy to go down.
Waved off as Usherov got in there and moves it ahead. Avalanche back at full strength as Forsberg leads them in. The pass comes back to Forsberg, cross ice, and it bounced over the stick of Foot. Adam Foot, watched by Ridley, spins away. Now leaves it for Forsberg, the backhand scores!
Here's the shot from Forsberg. That's in. That's off the back post and comes down under Kirk McLean. Here's another angle. There it is. It's off the middle bar.
Here's Chris Simon, rink wide, broken up, and now sent ahead. Here comes Joe Sakic with Young. Sakic scores through the pads, and it's 2-1.
Goal scorers always hit the net. This snapshot, Kirk McLean would like to have that one back. He's on the way down. He's usually a very good stand-up goaltender. There's no reason that he should be falling down on this one.
Dina Merzen has some words to cheer up his goaltender. That used to drive me nuts. Let's just keep going. Don't try and center me out. I know I let in a bad goal.
Now, Joe Sakic did not score a goal against the Canucks during the regular season, but has the go-ahead goal here at the 28-second mark of the second period. And Colorado with the first lead for the Avalanche in the game. Now Claude Lemieux's on the move. Lemieux trying to break through. Here's a shot. They score! Kamensky!
Forces the defense back. Alexander McGillney lets Valerie Kamensky go right by him, and again Kurt McLean is on the way down when it beats him. Alexander McGillney lets Kamensky go right by. McGillney's in no man's land. Kamensky is shooting the puck.
The goals come 25 seconds apart.
And here comes Corey Hirsch. And I knew that this would not take long for Pat Quinn to get Corey Hirsch some playoff experience. He didn't like the Sakic goal, I'm sure. The Kamensky one was so-so because Kamensky was in the middle. The defense had backed in. McGillney missed an assignment. But both those goals, and Kurt McLean's on his game. He's a stand-up goaltender.
Here comes Forsberg over the line. He'll drop it off. It's Kamensky. Lemieux heads to the front of the net. Kamensky down low. Forsberg centers and Oselin scores!
The puck movement of the Colorado Avalanche, and it's really hard to defend.
And he is sitting out. Here's another chance. Ricci, and he hit the goal post. Shots are deceiving in this period. 8-3 Colorado. It feels a lot more lopsided. Here's Tikkanen and scores! Esa Tikkanen left uncovered. And the Canucks get one back. Stopped by Lefebvre, but he gets it back again. It comes to the point. Avalanche trying to clear it out. They do, almost sending away Lemieux. Here he comes, Forsberg going to the net. Forsberg scores!
Lemieux to Forsberg. O'Coin is beaten with speed. Forsberg goes right by Hedekin. Look at this speed of Peter Forsberg. He sniffs a chance, and he just outskates Brett Hedekin. Perfect pass from Claude Lemieux, and not much chance for Corey Hirsch.
What a 1-2 punch they have with Sakic and Forsberg. Lane will give way tonight to Corey Hirsch. Usarov out to center after a strong opening game. Gets it on the left wing to Valerie Kamensky. Celebrating his 30th birthday. Centers it, Forsberg scores!
Talked about missed assignments. He was very angry after game one. You cannot let Valerie Kamensky outmuscle you behind the net. Kamensky on Leif Rolin throws the puck out. There's Forsberg cutting by Esa Tikkanen. Missed assignments. Rolin lets Kamensky throw it out. Tikkanen lets Forsberg fight through.
Couldn't get a stick on it. At the point of coin, throws it back in the corner. And Belanger comes off the board, tried to center it. And there's a shot, the goal, the red light is on. The Avalanche stopped up as if a whistle had gone, and Vancouver has tied it.
Gino Ogic just flattened Troy Murray beside the Avalanche net. Ben Mirawelli was looking the other way. Murray was still lying on the ice when that puck went in. And Mark Crawford is showing his displeasure. And Gino Ogic cross-checks Troy Murray in the back of the head. Down goes Murray, and there's no call. But the Avalanche stood around and watched. Ogic on Sylvain Lefebvre going to the net. A high stick. The Canucks felt they had to be more physical, and they played a more physical first 5 minutes. Gino Ogic does his job, goes in, gives Murray a shot, no penalty, and then he goes to the net. And when he goes to the net, he just tips it slightly, and it goes through.
Martin Jelena trying to spin away from a check. Couldn't get it out. And now Yell plays it back. Here's Mike Keane. That goes off Jelena. Uwe Krupp on the backhand. They score! It hit Ricci in front and deflects into the net.
And Corey Hirsch is calling high stick on this one, but I don't think it was. Mike Ricci was right in front of Corey Hirsch, and Pat Quinn is going to want it reviewed. This puck is just backhanded by Uwe Krupp, little backhander, and there's Mike Ricci, stick below his shoulders.
And now Dan Morwelli is
pointing
to center ice.
Well, we were right, Chris.
After the first shifts of the game, Lume's all tied up. Usarov couldn't get it out. Here's McGilney walking in front. Alexander McGilney scores! What a goal by McGilney! And the Canucks have tied it again. Oslich plays it ahead. Ricci and Young to the line, dropping it off for Simon. Back in it goes. Here's Young. The shot, they score! Oslich on the power play. Great shooting position in the slot. And now Jelena with the steal. Martin Jelena, short-handed, stopped by Waugh. But here's the Jelena opportunity.
There's Sakic just trying to play it off the boards. He fans on it. Jelena goes in. And
Gino Ojic tied it. Ricci put Colorado ahead. McGilney tied it. And then on the power play, Ozolich made it 3-2. Just failed to hit Kaminsky, streaking off the left wing. Forsberg shot, rebound. Sakic dropped by Hirsch. Hartnell dumps it in. Jelena after it. Ozolinch and Jelena in behind the net, and Martin Jelena kicks it loose. There's Hedekin leaving it. Hartnell in front. They score! Trevor Linden in front. I'm not sure if he touched it, but the Canucks have tied it again.
Trevor Linden did tip that one through Patrick Waugh. They've come out here in the second period. Here's Martin Jelena. He takes them. Sandis Ozolinch in. That creates a turnover. And now Trevor Linden goes to the front of the net. Russ Courtnell walks out. There's Trevor Linden. He tips it. It's off the post in behind Patrick Waugh. But they want that play close into Patrick Waugh across the crease.
The only nice pass to Linden. Here's a chance in front. And a great save by Patrick Waugh. No, it went in the net. Jelena redirecting it. And it's in.
Patrick Waugh got a piece of it. A nice pass from Trevor Linden. Jelena got enough of it. It hit Patrick Waugh, went up under the bar, and just dropped in over the line. Alexander McGilney to Trevor Linden, and Jelena goes to the net. Perfect pass by Trevor Linden. Jelena tips it. It's off Patrick Waugh's stick.
Cleared around by Murray, stopped up by McGilney. Beats the point. There's a shot off both posts. Handled by Patrick Waugh, and now Naslin has a chance. Naslin! And a big club stop by Patrick Waugh. Naslin's head. Two dangerous shots on consecutive shifts.
Naslin walks around Troy Murray, has the chance, and just snaps it. Patrick Waugh's well out. Gets that big red basket glove of his out to make the save. Naslin all sorts of room.
Low into the corner. Sakic and McGilney battling along the boards. And the battle continues. And McGilney wards off. There's a shot in front. Lume rotted loose. They score! Gino Ojic pouncing on the loose puck.
Gino second of the night. Adam Deadmarsh on Frank Kuchera. And Deadmarsh uses his strength, protects the puck, gets it out. Now Hirsch knows he's got it somewhere underneath his legs, but he keeps it strong. Puck's high, it's bouncing around. Cliff Ronick takes a swing at the puck, misses the puck, and hits Valerie Kaminsky right in the face. Kaminsky goes over to Dan Marrelli.
And Jerry Gauthier saw it. This time they get the appeal.
And now Trevor Linden comes charging across the ice.
Well, the Avalanche were on the linesman for not calling the Ojic cross-check in the first period. This time they get the call from Gauthier, and Linden's incensed.
Now both captains are over. And there's Valerie Kaminsky.
Here's a centering pass. Sakic right in, score!
A couple of posts, one where it hit both posts, this one from Russ Courtnell. Patrick Waugh's beaten high short side. And that's up the inside of the post again and out the other side.
That's at least three posts tonight. Naslin wrapped one off a couple of posts. That one seemed to beat Waugh. Ridley on the other side just missing. Along the wall, it comes loose for Kaminsky. Trying to center, and Linden there again. Trevor Linden trying to pin it. It comes out in front. Oselin shooting.